Hi all, in this video I'm going to introduce you with Radare, and what Radare is, it's a reverse engineering tool which assists you to disassemble the binary, debug it, and have a look of what the assembly code is and how it operates. So basically Radare is one of the most popular tool for doing reverse engineering, and it's a bit complex thing to understand how it operates, and in the beginning you might feel that it's not a good tool and you'll be frustrated using it. But once you learn it, you'll find yourself very much interested with it, and it has a lot of functionalities, and there's a good reason to use it because it is scalable. It has many of the utilities which ships with it, and it can be extended with the plugins as well, and it's a cross platform, so you can operate Radare on Windows or on Mac or in Linux, so you can use it everywhere. So that's the primary reason for using Radare, and to use it, first you need to in a few seconds. Next thing is printing and writing. So basically when we do reversing, these are the three most common operations we perform. Seeking means changing your current position to somewhere else in the memory. Printing is just printing the data or the assembly code located at that memory, and writing is changing the content, writing some commands there, and generally we write hex pairs to write the command. So the very first thing is how to launch R2 shell, and R2 is just an alias for Radare, and Radare 2 is the version of Radare. So this is just the alias for Radare 2. So how do we launch it? There are a few ways in which we can launch it. The very first way is this R2 space hyphen, and what it will do is simply launch Radare 2 binary and allocate 1024 bytes of space to it. So let's just fire up our terminal and launch Radare 2 this way, and yes, we launch Radare, and this section in the yellow, it represents the memory address at which we currently are. So let's take a look at this, and what it is, it opens Radare 2 without opening any files, so we are just getting into the Radare 2 shell. And these two generally are not very much used, but these two forms are used a lot of times. So this form is simple. It takes the file which you want to open with Radare 2 and will open it in disassemble mode. And what disassemble mode is, it will simply take this file, convert it into the assembly language and show you the assembly language. So if we do R2 bin ls, it will open it, and we are inside the binary, and this shows the memory address at which we currently are. And if we want to print the assembly at this current location, we can simply type in pd, and it will print the disassembly, and I'll talk of it later, but for now let's see another form, and I'll come to that printing and writing in a bit. So this will open Radare2 in debugging form. So what is the difference between disassembling and debugging? Disassembling is simply making the executable in a assembly form. So what it will do is simply take the binary, convert it into assembly language, and that's it. But in the debugging mode, it will not only disassemble the binary, but it will also allow us to debug it. Debugging means we can set up breakpoints and we can run the actual binary and see what exactly is happening. So basically, debugging mode is used whenever we need to debug, whenever we need to reverse a dynamic binary. That means evolve. And if you don't understand it at this moment, I'll come it. You will sooner understand it. So these are the few flags which are used. The very first flag is H, and what it does, it simply prints up the help message, and we can try it as well with H, and it simply prints up the help message. And we have a lot of other, like this capital A. This is used to analyze the code, in which is the assembly code. And we have this A flag. This is used to define the architecture. It could be 64 or x86. Then there is a B flag, C flag, I flag, and we will come to each of them as we need it. So now coming to printing. So as I said, you let's just open bin ls in debug mode. Now how do we print the disassembly? So we have several different ways. The first way is we just type in x and it will print up the stack. This is the, it will print up the hexadecimal disassembly language. So if you see, these are the offsets, these are the hexadecimal values which are stored, and this is the stack type structure. So what if we want to print only 3? We can simply type in 3x and it will print 3 hexadecimal pairs. And if you want to look at what instruction these hexadecimal pairs represents, you can just simply type in pd and it will print in a good form in which we can understand. Let's just maximize it. So basically we are here, it shows the instruction pointer is here, this RIP, and these are the hex pairs 31ED, and this represents this instruction ZOR EBP and EBP. And this operation simply is equal to EBP equal to 0. As we know, ZORing two operands which are same results in 0. So that's a convenient way in assembly language to assign a assign a integer value to 0. And we'll come to more of these assemblies later on as we require. Now the another way of using PD is, and this PD refers to print disassemble. So and this 3, this refers to print only 3 instructions. So if we do PD 5, we will have 5 instructions, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if we want only print a specific number of instructions, we can use it in this form. Now another thing which we want is we want to go to the main function. By default, when we start radar, it goes to this entry point and stops execution there if we open it in debug mode. In assembly mode, it will just point into this location. So to go to the main location, we need to go into the main function, and to do this we have seek command, and S is used to go to some specific location. So we can use it in this form, and we will, now we are inside the main function, and the address here is changed, which represents that we are somewhere else. Now if we do pd, we see we are in the main function. So that's seek command. Let me clear the screen. Now another form of print disassemble is using this at the rate operand, and what this at the rate operand does is it simply perform this instruction at this memory location. That means if we want to print disassembly here, we just simply type in pd3 and it will print 3 assembly instructions. But what if we want to print the disassembly at somewhere else location? In that case, we use the at the rate operator, and when we do it like this, entry 0, it will print up the disassembly at this memory location, entry 0, instead of printing it at the current location. So if we use it this way, it will print up the disassembly at current location, and if we do it this way, it will print the disassembly at this address. Similarly, we can use pointers as well. So if we want to print the disassembly at instruction pointer, we can use it this way. If we want to print only specific number of, then we can use it this way. Similarly, X, this is refers to print hex pairs. If we print 10 hex pairs, we have 10 hex pairs here. Actually, sorry, this way it is used. And this colon, this is semicolon. This semicolon is used to concatenate two radar commands in the same line. So if we do something like seek main colon print disassemble 5, it will go to main and then print the 5 disassembly instructions. Actually, we are inside main, that's why the address didn't change. So if we do it to somewhere else, okay, so first it does this instruction which simply changes the location to entry 0, and then it printed up the 5 instructions. So this is it. Next thing is this symbol called grep, internal grep inside Radare2, and this is a bit similar to the grep utility in bash. So if we want to grep something, we use this. For example, if we want to print disassemble 5 instructions and grep any move command, we can simply do it and it will print all the commands which have move inside them. Now flags are also very useful while doing calculations, and Radare provides you a very convenient way of doing calculations using something called this question mark operator. And what it does is it simply calculate the values and prints in. So we can use it in many ways. If we want to do simple calculations, we do this and we get this result, and this result contains everything. In decimal it is 2, in hexadecimal it is 0x2, and so on. And it also prints the ASCII as well. So what if we want to know what this character belongs to in ASCII, then we can simply do it this way. And you can see in decimal it is 65, and this 65 corresponds to A in ASCII. So this is quite handy tool for doing calculations, and it'll be very helpful. We can define flag in this way. The F refers to F actually can be used for many things. If we type in F, we got a lot of things. And what this thing is, we can simply do something like fs and then print in. So we can use f to print strings, symbols, sections, imports, and so on. So if we want to print all the strings inside the binary, we can simply do it this way. So it will print all the ASCII strings in the binary, and you can do it this way as well, fs strings and then print in f. And if you want to look at the symbols or imports are quite handy while doing reverse engineering. So you can see which libraries the function is importing. Some of them are very useful, like memcopy, and there are others, fscanf, and imports give you a really juicy stuff while doing reverse engineering. Now printing bytes, as I said, we can print something in Radare using p, and we can use printing in many forms. If we want to print hex pairs, we can simply do it p and then a number. It will print hexadecimal. And if we want to print in d word or q word form, then we can use pxw or pxq. And this is a double word form in which all the hex pairs are in 32 bits. That means if we do simple printing, we get hex pairs in bytes. But if we do in q word, we get it as 32 bits, actually 4 bytes. And in q words there are 8 bytes. Sorry, in q word there are 64 bits, and we have this in this way. Q refers to quad word. That means it consists of 4 words, and 4 words mean one word has 2 bytes, so 4 words has 8 bytes. So PXQ is 8 bytes long. And this thing is actually advanced stuff, so I will not cover it in this video. Now coming to disassembling, there is a list of commands here as well. What if we want to print the disassembly only instructions? So if we print in pd, it gives us a lot of things, like the address where the instruction is stored, the instructions hex pairs, and the instruction. But what if we only are interested in instructions? So in that case, we can print it using PI. So if we use PI, it will only print the instructions and nothing else. So that's a very good thing. And another thing is PA, and this is also and PAD. These are also very handy tools. And what it does is, if we type in PA question mark, we get information about how it does and how it works. And in Radar, there is a good support of help. So if you type in question mark, you get all the help regarding all the commands. And Radar basically works on regex. So it just search, when it sees this question mark, it simply determines that help is needed to be printed. So these are the things which these are the commands, and these also have sub commands, like if it have this list unload R2 plugins, we can simply type in capital L and then question mark, it will print all the commands associated with this particular functionality and the syntax of it. So if we type in PA question mark, we get help about how to use. So PA is print assemble, so it will simply assemble the code we give it to it, like a simple instruction. So if we want to know what this instruction will actually look in hex form, then we can use this print assemble functionality. Another thing is print assemble disassemble, and this is just the reverse of assembling. In this, we just simply disassemble the hex pair. So if we do in this way, we get this. So if we disassemble 90, then it will print up the knob. So knob is simply no operation. So if we want to assemble knob, we can do it this way. And this is also quite handy when we are required to change the segments of code and we don't know what the hex pair corresponding to the particular instruction will be. So in that case, we need this. Now there is something very interesting in Radar called ESIL, and what it does is it emulates the code. That means it provides you a bit of high level like things that what actually the code is going to do. So if we type in this, we look that it is false by default, but we can turn it true, and the syntax to do is this. Now if we query, this is true. And if we print disassembly now, we will see here this section in red. This simply emulates what is actually this instruction is pretending to be done, or is or what Radar thinks what this instruction will do. So this is not always true, but this is quite handy to understand the logic of the code and is really, really good to have. Now Radar also comes with something called Resum, and this is also very handy for assembling and disassembling the code. And this does the same what we did with this PA and PAD. So you can use Radare2 as well as PA. Now coming to seeking, we have several forms of seeking. So basically we can seek to something like this way, or we can seek using a memory address, and when we do this, we are now at this memory address, and there is a visual editor as well in Radare, which we can invoke by typing simply V, and it will give us a more good way of looking the assembly. Now you can change this mode by using the P key. So if you type in P, it will change the let me first turn off the emulation so that it is easy to see. Now if you see, this is quite good and quite easy to read, and we can also change this view as well using P. So we have quite of different ways. In this we have our registers, our stacks there, and the assembly. You can use up and down keys to go through the code, or you can, if you want to run any command here, you can simply type in colon and then it will give you this cursor, and you can type in any command you want. For example, I want to type in db to list breakpoints here. I can simply type in db, press enter, and it will list the breakpoints which are there in there, and if we type in enter, it will vanish it. Now another cool thing is there is something called graph mode in Radare. So if we go to our main function, now if we want to take a graphical view just like we do in IDA Pro and similar utilities, we can simply type in VV and it will drop us to graph mode. And here we did not have anything because we haven't still analyzed the code. So first we need to analyze the code, and when we will analyze the code, it will do following things. It will check all the function calls, check for all cross function references, and so on. Now if we type in VV, we are inside the main function and it is like a graphical view. Okay, so we are inside main function, and you can use arrow keys to go up and down, left and right. And if you want to take a look at registers and so on, you can simply type in exclamation mark, and when you type in exclamation mark, it will give you another view like this. And here you have disassembly, you have symbols, stack, registers, references, and you can switch to them using tab. So you can, if you want to look registers, go to there, type in enter, and have a good look of registers, stack, and so on. So that's quite handy as well. And another most beautiful thing I like about Radare is another view which you can access typing P, and so if you just come to you see a flow diagram of code, and here is the code belonging to this location at the rate. So if you type in end tab, you will be in next code block. So if you want to analyze code blocks, you can do it this way. And if you have a true false condition anywhere, you can simply type in T or F to follow the block. So here we have two conditions. This red is false and it will give you here, it will take you here, and we have our true condition which will take you here. So if you want to take a true, you can simply type in T and we are here. We followed the So you can use it this way as well. If we type in F, we followed the false, and if we type in true, we followed the true block. And I guess that's all for this video. I hope you like watching it, and if you have any doubt or any suggestions, you are strongly recommended to comment and share this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, Admiral Ghost.